Hi there, Florin here. Today I have a follow-up video on my DIY water-cool GPU project. This time I come with an improvement to the original design. I managed to get a sheet of metal that is 3mm thick. I've seen such metal plates for sale on the market, but I had this lying around my house, so it didn't cost me anything. I will be building a custom plate for my GPU on which I can attach virtually any Intel CPU cooler. I can't use any pre-built Corsair or NZXT plates since my GPU has a custom PCB. I also can't recommend using the NZXT plate anyway since it doesn't seem to have any memory chip cooling. And believe me, those chips are getting really hot while gaming. The first thing I need to do is to make a template of the final plate using a sheet of paper on which I'll draw every screw hole by using the original cooler. I'm using my pen to punch a hole, then put in a screw just to make sure the paper doesn't move and end up with holes in the wrong location. I also make sure the paper is straight when I'm making my holes. I then start marking the lines for the more delicate parts. After every detail of the plate is drawn, I cut all the excess. I was lucky to have a bent edge for more heat dissipation, so I'll be leaving that in place, but I guess you can also bend the metal using a vise. Next, I went and fixed my plate with some tape and with a 90 degree ruler I draw the lines using a marker. After this, with my screwdriver, I mark all the screw holes. Now to make the first cuts. I make sure to have protective eyewear when doing this. It's better safe than sorry. I take my time here and do the cuts as straight as possible. The cut edges are hot, so I try to avoid touching any of those now. For the smaller parts, I had to use a Dremel to make the cuts. Filed off any imperfections and checked again with the paper template. Next, I've marked the original GPU location and then I came with the Intel bracket of my HATI cooler to see how I can best fit it on my plate. I then mark the holes that I'll be using to mount the cooler. After this, I need to mark the part that I'll be cutting to make my pump fit. Since I had the cooler already installed on my PC, I choose to draw it by approximation using the bracket. Now it's time to drill the holes for the screws. And the moment of truth. Does it fit? Mostly yes. I ended up with through holes that doesn't quite fit. I've marked the direction in which my hole should be, and then with the drill I started to enlarge the hole in that direction. Now, I need to cut the centerpiece where the pump will sit. Since some of the screws that I'll be using to fix the Intel bracket will sit straight on top of the memory chips, I need to countersink them using this bit. I need to be sure the screw's head will be flush with the rest of the plate. Now, I test to see if everything fits and look for any components that might get crushed or get in the way of the plate, and do the necessary cuts. Because of a blunder, I ended up cutting on the wrong side of the plate, but it wasn't all that critical. Next, I installed the screws that will hold the pump and make some tests. Here I'm using 3mm screws that are 10mm long. but I do recommend having at least 50mm long screws for a better fit. I used a bolt on the other side to have the screw secured in place. Now I took liberty in sanding down the plate a bit of any dirt before making a small paint job. I only painted the side that I'll be seeing. Next step is to clean up the GPU and prepare the thermal pads. I'm using 1mm thick pads with a heat transfer rating of 8 watts per metric Kelvin. These pads have plastic covers on each side, so be sure to remove those before installation. At this point I realized that there are a few areas that have small components which might short when I install the plate, so I covered those with electrical tape. I'm not sure if those are higher than the memory chips themselves, but I don't want to risk it. I removed the plastic covers on the other side of the pads, cleaned the plate with alcohol and then I installed it. I think this plate is looking quite good. Now I apply the thermal paste and install the pump. Due to my screws being only 10mm long, I found it a bit difficult to install, but it eventually worked out. At this point I decided to reuse a part from my initial mod. I've installed an extra radiator on top of 3 components and some memory chips. And that's about it. The car looks much better with this plate than with the small heatsinks that I've been used in my initial mod. I could also make the plate accommodate a larger fan for the VRM side, but I choose not to do it because I have a large 100mm fan on silent mode blowing air on the whole card. Since this plate is done with Intel screw location, I can virtually mount any Intel CPU cooler that I please in the future. That's it for today. Like the video if you liked it and have a nice day.